2019 is here. So it's time for me to make that same bad joke I make every year and reflect on what was most important in 2018. The toys. There were a lot of great toys released in 2018. It's always hard for me to sit down and compile a list of all of my favorites, but I think that I've done it. And yes, this is exactly that. My favorite toys. Since tastes are different, everyone will and should have a different list of favorite toys for the year. So watch this video where I talk about all of my favorites, then you guys can tell me about your favorites. Let's get right into it. This is Pixel Dan's 10 favorite toys of 2018. I love Rampage. It's one of those arcade games that really brings me back to my childhood. I remember going to the local skating rink and spending all of my time pumping quarters into the Rampage machine instead of actually roller skating. And thanks to the feature film on the video game being released this year, Rampage got a ton of merchandise, and I bought a lot of it. Stretchy monsters based on the video game, a miniature arcade with a fully playable game, and heck, I even got the Rampage arcade one-up machine as a Christmas gift. But one of the coolest toys that isn't even based on the game is the Mega George from Lanard. Following up on their impressive King Kong figure from the prior year, this large-scale action figure includes more articulation and a fairly nice sculpt. It also includes a small 3¾-inch figure of The Rock, and while it's definitely not anything too impressive, George himself is a crazy amount of fun. I'm a sucker for big, fun monster toys, especially when it's easy to walk into the store and just buy them for an affordable price. Retailing for only $20, you just can't beat the fun of a figure like this. Full disclosure here, I was involved in the marketing campaign for the DC Savage World line from Funko, and QC issues have plagued the Amazon releases of the line, which is disappointing. But the Batcave playset truly stands out to me as one of my favorite toys that I opened up in 2018. As a massive fan of the original Masters of the Universe toy line, as well as similar 5.5-inch scaled action figures, this playset is right up my alley. An obvious nod to the vintage Castle Grayskull, which is one of my all-time favorite playsets, the Batcave is designed to pay homage to the barbarian style that was hugely popular in the 1980s. The deep blue bat-shaped playset opens up in a similar style as those vintage castles, revealing fun accessories inside, such as a crystal ball, a bone ladder, a throne. Whether you use this for your DC Savage World action figures, or you want to populate it with your own vintage action figures, this is a really well done and incredibly fun toy that serves as a love letter to an era that I adore. This Batcave playset is set to start showing up at Target stores in 2019 with the Savage World action figures, which, by the way, will be updated versions of the figures to fix the QC issues of the Amazon releases. So that is definite good news right there. 2018 was the year of the dinosaurs. With the release of Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom, the toy world was packed with new dino toys, including official releases for the new film. And I gotta say, Mattel brought it with their Jurassic World line. Getting the license from Hasbro, Mattel went all in and released some pretty downright fun and amazing toys. The Indoraptor is just one. A downright amazingly fun toy. This is the made-up villain dinosaur from the new film, and while I didn't really love the dinosaur in the actual film, I seriously fell in love with this toy. It's one of the only collector-friendly releases in Mattel's line, being given the super articulated treatment. The sculpt is fantastic, and the paint deco is awesome, giving him a shiny, metallic look to his scaled body. Dinosaurs never go out of style. Dinosaurs always make for good toys, and as it turns out, Mattel makes great dinosaur toys. I love video games, and I love toys that are based on video games. Every year, at least one video game action figure makes my list. Last year, the awesome Mortal Kombat Scorpion figure from Storm Collectibles was high up on my list. And while I loved the multicolored ninjas, I noted in that video that I couldn't wait to get a non-ninja character. Enter Shao Kahn in 2018. This figure is massive, and his accessories are awesome. He comes with this throne for crying out loud, and he looks so amazing sitting on it. Storm has been doing a pretty incredible job with the Mortal Kombat license. The figures are beautifully sculpted, nicely articulated, and come with some pretty awesome accessories. And I love that they are embracing the classic Mortal Kombat designs for this line. For someone who was deeply entrenched in the original Mortal Kombat vs. Street Fighter War of the 1990s, these figures are a dream come true. I haven't had the chance to grab Goro yet, but I definitely will, and I look forward to collecting even more from this line in 2019. So many Marvel Legends in 2018. A lot of great stuff to be sure, and I'll be perfectly honest, I just can't keep up with them all. I am not a diehard Marvel Legends collector. I mostly just cherry pick, which of course is hard when there's a Build-A-Figure that I want. But I did end up with my fair share of Legends in 2018, and I loved a lot of them. In fact, that Wolverine from the X-Men wave was real close to making this list, but the one Marvel Legends figure that does make my list of favorites is Spider-Ham. I love this figure. It's just ridiculously fun. Counted as one of those figures that I wasn't sure we'd ever actually see released. And I know that him being such a smaller figure, it's hard to swallow the full Marvel Legends figure price for him. But Hasbro did package him with the largest Build-A-Figure piece for this particular wave, so if you're someone who collects the Build-A-Figures, at least he's got that going for him. But his bonus accessory is genius. A pork grind head that you can plop on your Venom figure? I love it. Plus, Into the Spider-Verse was an awesome movie, which certainly is what paved the way for Hasbro to finally release Spider-Ham in the Marvel Legends lineup. I freaking love it. Oh yeah, there's more Jurassic World on this list, but man, like I said, Mattel seriously brought it this year. While the aforementioned Indoraptor was nicely articulated and sculpted and worthy of being dubbed a collector's figure, the colossal Tyrannosaurus Rex is just straight up one of the most fun dinosaur action figures ever made. The T-Rex is king when it comes to dinos, and this toy is worthy of that king title. She stands around 15 inches tall and is 42 inches in length. And not only is this a gigantic toy, but it also has a key feature. She can eat your action figures. That's right, the mouth is big enough to open up and swallow a lot of your smaller toys and action figures, which then slide down into the hollow belly of the toy. They can be easily removed by opening a small compartment on the underside, and if that's not enough, there's also a Walmart exclusive version, which features battle damage and has a roaring sound effect when the mouth is opened. And the toy looks great. I don't care if you're a kid or a kid at heart. This is an amazing toy, and I dare you not to love it. The excellent toy designers known as Four Horsemen Toy Design have been on a roll with their original property, Mythic Legions. The line had quite a massive 2018 with the release of several figures, including the introduction of female figures to the lineup. There were so many amazing figures launched this year. Seriously, I have a whole stack of them that I haven't even had a chance to open up yet. This makes it really hard to name just one Mythic Legions figure to add to this list because I've been incredibly impressed with all of the figures in this line, but there is one particular figure that I really just completely adore. The giant known as Brontus. This orange-skinned Cyclops isn't the first giant released in the Mythic Legions line, but it instantly became my favorite of the batch. Standing 11 inches tall, Brontus has an amazingly detailed sculpt that the Four Horsemen are known for. And in great details like a fur loincloth, a real metal chain you can put around his neck, and a giant skull-bashing club, you've got an amazing monster toy. A decade later, and Masters of the Universe Classics is still going strong. Super 7 did have a bit of a rocky start when they first took the line over, but I really feel like they stepped it up in 2018. The few QC issues we ran into, they did a pretty great job of addressing. And honestly, they gave us several really great figures that could totally be on this list. But I have to give a solid nod to a few figures like Karg, a figure that I never thought we'd get, Filmation Merman, and Quake, one of my favorite weirdos from New Adventures. Those were definitely some of my favorite Masters figures of the year, but the one that stands out the most has got to be Dial-A-Mug. Talk about a character that I never thought we'd see in the line. This guy completely breaks the mold. Back when Mattel was in charge of Masters of the Universe Classics, we always heard that the figures had to be built on the same basic body, making this guy completely impossible, since he would have to be a 100% unique sculpt. Not only did Super 7 release several figures this year with a ton of new parts, but they also did it perfectly with Dial-A-Mug here. He's got an action feature as well, allowing you to make multiple facial expressions, and it's a really awesome touch. I love this figure, and I'm super excited to see what else comes our way for this line in 2019. Keep that Motu coming! Last year, the brand new Bucky O'Hare action figure from Boss Fight Studio was my number one favorite release of 2017. And in 2018, they ranked high again with the release of Deadeye Duck. I love this figure. Another amazing update, this new Deadeye Duck features four fully posable arms, interchangeable parts, and a gorgeous sculpt and paint deco that make it look like he leapt straight off the cover of a classic Bucky O'Hare comic book. The collector-friendly packaging that allows you to remove the figure to display it loose and then place it back on the car for a carded display option is amazing, especially with that rad artwork that totally gives off a retro vibe, evoking those nostalgic feels over the original Hasbro toy line. And the best part is that the line is still pushing forward. The Storm Toad Trooper was released right at the end of the year, and Bruiser the Berserker Baboon is next up for 2019. I am a big fan of the original Hasbro line, and I always hated that it didn't reach its full potential. So I am so amped to see Boss Fight really doing these characters justice and releasing some amazing new action figures. I almost don't know what else to say about this particular TMNT set that I didn't say in two videos that I made about it back in July. Wait, yes I do. This set is a dream come true. When NECA released their quarter-scale Turtles action figures based on the 1990 movie, I was blown away by the amazing sculpts, and I knew that I had to own them even though I don't typically go for that scale of an action figure. They are amazing, and I never regretted my purchase. But with every new TMNT release from NECA at conventions, I kept hoping and bugging Randy that we might see these amazing movie figures released in the smaller 6-inch scale. And then it happened in 2018. The figures were just as gorgeous as the larger versions, complete with new features such as interchangeable bandana pieces for various ways to display them. They also included all of the amazing accessories we saw with the larger figures, plus they came in an amazing box inspired by the original VHS cover for the movie. A cover that no doubt all of us are very familiar with, since we all watched this movie until the tape wore out when we were kids. And to top it all off, I was even name dropped on the back of the packaging. A complete surprise that I learned about when the box showed up at my doorstep. That makes me a small piece of TMNT history, and I couldn't be more honored. Seriously, how could this not be my number one pick? It is so amazing in every way. Thank you, NECA Toys. I cannot wait to see what else you guys have planned for us in 2019. So there you go, 10 really fun, really awesome toys that came out in 2018 that I happen to like quite a bit. So, Now it's the moment you've all been waiting for. Use that comment section down below to tell me how wrong I am and list your favorite toys. But for real, guys, there's no wrong answer here. Toys are awesome, and I can't wait to see what 2019 brings for all of us. Until next time.